Spring is one of the best times to go out in the garden and just enjoy. And what you can do is divide your plants. You can divide everything from liriope and hostas and epimediums and daylilies and Solomon's seal. These are just plants that you dig up out of the ground carefully. You shake the soil off as best you can. Sometimes you have to wash them, and then you either pull them apart or divide them with knives or hatchets. The reason I like spring is these plants really haven't grown much. You know, they're only maybe a half an inch. Some haven't even popped up out of the ground. So when you divide them and you plant them back in the garden, they just take off like a rocket and send out brand new roots. But just go out in the garden and pull off all the dead foliage. This is a daylily, just like this. Now, sometimes people ask how frequently you divide. Some plants you can divide every year, but I recommend maybe one time every 3 to 5 years. And so here your daylily's ready. Then you just take your shovel and you come right around and just dig right around the daylily, just like this. And usually what I like to do is just cut all the way around it so it's easy to lift when you're done. And then just make that final cut, just like this. And I find if you just drop it, it shakes a lot. Sometimes you'll come back in and do it again. Pick it up, take the top part of the shovel, and shake it just like this. If you're lucky, you can just take your hands and pull apart the plants. But if it's a really old, mature plant, I'm going to show you what you do with those. A couple of my favorite tools, of course, a little sharp razor if you need to divide those little plants. I also like a stiff knife, not a knife that bends, because knives that bend and warp can cut you if you're not careful. But my favorite is a meat cleaver, and this is when you have a really bad day, take it out on your plants. What I've got here is some plants that are all ready to be divided. They have been shaken, and they've also been washed. And sometimes when you're dealing with little plants, this is a small hosta called lemon lime, and each bud means one plant. So it's been washed, ready to go, and what I do is carefully take my knife. In some cases, you can pull plants out, or you need to gently take your knife. That is a plant. Now, for most of us in our own garden usage, I really like a bigger plant, something like this, because you're going to get your return on the plant, and you're going to get a flower on it. It's going to fill in better if it's larger. Of course, we have daylilies, and many of us are familiar with Stella di Oro. This is a plant, if you divide every year, in less than 10 years, you'll have 20,000 plants. And again, you can make your plants as small as this, or just take your knife. And the key with dividing daylilies is you've got to take your knife, make sure you use the sharp side down, insert your knife and twist it, and you'll hear a crack. Just don't chop the plant. And what I might do is cut this again in half. I might make 5 plants out of this. Now, for those really tough plants, a knife really doesn't work, but I'm going to use my meat cleaver. This is a hosta, but this hosta just makes a few plants, and you just put your hand behind your back at all times. You know, a lot of us have a tendency to rearrange the plant. Just, and there's your plant. It's that easy. And if you want to divide things like liriope that have foliage, just, you know, you can pull them apart. But the important thing, as I mentioned earlier, if there's any foliage present on the plants, you're ready to go, fill up your garden, or give your plants to your neighbors. I'm Mark Viette. Join me next time in the garden.
For more garden tips, use the internet to click on the In the Garden website, inthegardenradio.com.